for a woman to commit a crime, it was more horrendous than it was picturing a man committing a crime. Because men in the world seem like they can be violent. But a woman, you're supposed to be a nurturer. You're supposed to be doing the kids and helping the kids. So it's less likely that a woman would do these things in America's eyes. But when it happens, it's like we're deemed even more dangerous than a man. So what's special about the people at the People's Pottery Project is we are formerly incarcerated. We have all been searching for the same thing, and it was just to build our confidence and be able to come back into society not having those qualms about how people feel about us. Prior to co-founding People's Pottery Project, I was offered a job by the artist Molly Larkey, and I needed the job because I was doing life in prison. And when you do life in prison, you have to go in front of parole board, which is a commissioner and a deputy commissioner, and you have to have a job lined up. You have to be able to tell them why you committed your crime, what circumstances can you do to change if you were put in the same predicament. You basically have to sell yourself in front of the parole board in hopes that they do find you suitable or find that whatever is coming from your heart or out of your mouth is truth. And it's really hard because 9 out of 10 times if you don't have a job lined up, more or less likely you will not get suitable for parole. When you come out of prison, normally you're not known by your name, but you're known by what you did. So if you know how society looks at people that have been formerly incarcerated, the first thing they think of is violence. This is just the stereotype that America has placed on people who have been formerly incarcerated. It saddens me because a lot of us just, we made a bad decision. It only took 30 seconds and it changed our lives. That doesn't necessarily mean that's who we are, it's just what we did. So when they see our pottery, they're like, oh, this is so beautiful. And then they get our card and they see who's behind the pottery. Because they saw beauty before they saw who made it, it allowed them to accept us into the community without judgment, because they saw beauty before they saw the paperwork that comes from behind us. And it's amazing how the community, after seeing our bowls, have joined hands and like supported us. It's very overwhelming at times to think that people who are strangers look at us and want to stand by us and want to help us. And then they start carrying our mission and they pass that forward, which is what we hope to do, change hearts and minds one at a time. Coming out from prison, you kind of become institutionalized after so many years. You're told what to do. Everything is structured. So coming out here and having to make my own decisions, it was almost impossible for me to do. I was waiting for somebody to tell me what my next move was supposed to be. And that in itself is like, I'm a grown woman. How come it's so hard for me to make a decision? It was because I was used to being told, get up at 6, go to lunch at 11. Every unlock is 15 minutes before and 15 minutes after. At 4:30, it's count time. The doors are locked. At 6 o'clock, we'll open the doors again. So for me to have free rein of just opening a door, it was hard. It was really hard. I at times I felt, man, prison is much, much better. And freedom is all I've been wanting for all these years. How come it's so hard? When I first got ceramics, I was like, what is this? But then when I started feeling the clay and molding it and seeing after it was fired and after I glazed it, the beautiful product that came out, it nearly melted my heart, because I was like, oh my God, I can really create something beautiful. Because in my head, after being there for so long and told that you're a bad person, you know, you're just another number, you're never gonna make it, you're never going home. So being home and seeing that all these things in my head keep replaying to me, that this is who I am supposed to be, this is what they're telling me I am, but then actually doing something, having the environment around me where we're all talking and we're all comforting and making something beautiful, and then being able to give it to the public and them accept it. It's just such a nice healing process that I don't think I would have been able to get anywhere else. You know, the art community is so positively responsive. We try to give back by showing the good things that we can produce from hands that were so-called violent. And what our mission is to empower women, non-binary, and trans who are formerly incarcerated, giving them positions, jobs, and helping them build confidence to where when they do go out and find a different job, or if they choose to stay with us, they don't feel insecure in the community as if they don't belong.